The Lord said there was not going to be no peace in this day and age, man. All right? Ain't no peace, man. It's going to be nothing but trouble, man. Tribulation. That's what you people need to look forward to, man. Just mass death. All right? You're going to see more signs in the heavens. All right? You're going to see a lot of out of the ordinary occurrences take place. Look forward to all those different things, man.
Laws being passed that are unrighteous.
All these executive orders passed by your government in the way of puppet boy Obama.
Up it.
All right? Look forward to that, man. The devil is using Obama, man. Our people was damn near worshiping that God.
And he's a willing servant.
Yeah, man, that was damn near worshiping that God 7 years ago, man. That man is pulling out his horns, man.
Straight up.
He's giving more rights to the transgenders and homosexuals
than
you real men out there.
You still
want to put up a picture of Monkey Boy Obama, man? That dude's a sodomite, man.
Speak on what you talked about earlier, bro, about the transvestites going to out-push the women.
Yeah, man.
Taking the women's rights.
Yeah, man, they have a saying now where they're coming up with a decree where you can't no longer call a pregnant woman, you can't call her a mother or a pregnant woman. You gotta call her a pregnated individual. You can't call her a pregnant mother or you can't say the word mother. That's discriminatory
towards the
transgenders. You know, so they're pushing for shit like that, man.
Crazy. Right.
And not to mention last week when we found out that these devils that came up with baby dildos.
Yeah.
All right. So they're pretty much showing you what type of sick, twisted, perverse society we living in. All right. That's the standard of morality to the people on high, man. LGBT. You might as well add a P to the end of that because pedophilia is the next thing, man. LGBTP, man. Pedophilia is bestiality, right?
Bestiality. LGBTP.
Matter of fact, change the P to F, man. To freakism. Because that's exactly what that is, man.
LGBTBP. Beastie and pedophilia.
That's right, man.
Add two more letters to that.
We'll go back to where you was at. No, Revelation 12. I mean, you get what you get. Go back to
Revelation 12. Woe to the inhabitants of the earth and the sea, for the devil is come down unto you having great wrath, because he knoweth he have but a short time.
Yeah, he know that clock is ticking, man. That's why he's going so hard, man.
Where's the solid?
Here we go. The executive order. On his site, the White House, it's the Executive Order National Security Medal. By virtue of the authority vested in me as President of the United States and as Commander-in-Chief of the Armed Forces of the United States, it is hereby ordered as follows, Section 1 Policy, in order to more appropriately recognize distinguished achievements and outstanding contributions in the field of national security, Executive Order 10431 of January 19, 1953, as amended as follows. It says, Section 2 is amended to read as follows. The National Security Medal may be awarded to any person without regard to nationality, including members of the armed forces of the United States, for distinguished achievement or outstanding contribution made on or after July 26, 1947, in the field of national security to either exceptionally meritorious service performed in a position of high responsibility or through an act of heroism requiring personal courage of a high degree and complete disregard of personal safety. So they're pretty much awarding those, regardless of your nationality, if you're down with the system, and you down with national security, which national security, they pretty much execute the laws of these orders, they enforce these orders. You pretty much like they're being awarded, man. So if they are awarding these men, it's gonna cause these men to get
ramp
more
up.
Lifted up.
Ramp up.
They're gonna ramp up and they're gonna wanna start dealing with you people, man. All right. It says that was just one select. That was just one executive order.
13603.
Yep.
How about that one?
Yep. Go back to your script, bro.
Verse 12. Therefore rejoice, ye heavens, and ye that dwell in them. Woe to the inhabitants of the earth and the sea, for the devil has come down unto you having great wrath, because he knoweth that he hath but a short time.
And he know he has but a short time, man. So he's going to use God's puppets like Obama to sign these different executive orders to further oppress you people out here, man. All right? And not just here in America, man. Because the Illuminati, man, they pulling the strings everywhere, man. All right? They're the ones that's funding both sides of the war. All right? They getting this thing going, man. They're the ones that sent the Pope to come over here and address the New World Order. And speak the perverseness that the Pope was speaking. This devil is desperate, man. All right?
And then he playing both sides, Slocky. When the Pope came over here, he had a meeting with Kim Davis, the white woman who denied the homosexuals the marriage licenses. Yep. He had a private meeting with this woman. He invited this woman, went and picked this woman up, and told her that he was grateful for her courage. And then when he went back to the Vatican, he made a statement and sent out a press release saying that his meeting with that woman was no way in regards the endorsement that he agreed with her. Mind you, she can't have a meeting with the Pope. He had to have a meeting with her. So why is he having a meeting with this woman and congratulating her and then going back and saying what she did, he don't endorse it? That's the devil right there.
That's the devil, man. That's the devil straight up in hell, man. Only the devil would do something.
Only
like
the
that.
Devil would do that. But because of the unicorn, he couldn't hide it. We found out.
That's right. Go ahead, bro.
Keep going. What about y'all? Revelations 2 and 10. Fear none of these things which thou shalt suffer. Behold, the devil shall cast some of you into prison that ye may be tried, and ye shall have tribulations 10 days. Be thou faithful to death, and I will give thee a crown of life.
So it's coming a point in time where this devil is going to start casting you into the prisons, man. What's another name for a prison? A prison camp. A concentration camp. A detention center.
AKA FEMA camp.
FEMA camps. All right, and that's the plan for this New World Order, man. To get all of you people that oppose the New World Order they're going to round you people up and put you in these detention centers by way of FEMA.
Slop you out.
And they're going to be torturing you people, and a lot of you they're going to be killing, especially if you are on that that list. All right? You ain't going to make it out of there. The bulk of you that are weak, they're going to be indoctrinating people in there, man. And they're going to be trying to teach you the ways of the New World Order and for you to get down with the program. All right? So brothers that get caught up in that, they're going to have to be martyrs, man.
That's right.
And then there's going to be certain brothers that are not a portion to it. They're going to be able to escape that.
That's right.
So the Lord's going to deliver them. All right? The 144,000 and the one-third is going to be delivered. But the rest of these people, they got to look up. They got to look forward to that. All right? It's not a religion. No, it's just the truth of the Bible. Read that again.
Revelations 2 and 10. Fear none of those things which thou shalt suffer. Yep. Behold, the devil shall cast some of you into prison.
Yep.
That you may be tried.
That you're going to be tried, man. A lot of you people, your faith is going to be tried, which the majority of you people out here, you don't have faith to begin with.
That's right.
All right? It's going to be easy for you to take that chip, which is the mark of the beast. All right? You people are going to fold just because as soon as you go 3 days without food and you know you're going to have the chip in order for you to feed your family, you're going to give right in. Or if you're in a concentration camp and they torturing your family, you're going to be begging and pleading with them to not kill your family, and in order for you to do that, you're going to take the chip. All right, you're going to fold, man. So that's how the devil's going to try the majority of our people, man. All right?
Slack it. Hillary called the FEMA camps re-education camps.
That's exactly what that is, man.
She said that American adults need to be re-educated. That's Hillary Clinton.
That's right, man. Hey, and Obama Salakia, going back to the executive orders, earlier this year, Obama signed an executive order to deal with any cyber attacks, man. And we know that when the government does PSYOPs and false flags, cyber attacks are included in false flags, man.
That's right. Internet is flooded with false information.
With false information, man. So that's another way of them controlling you, gaining control of your minds, and basically bringing authority over you, man. You people don't even realize that the government is pretty much an organization that controls you and your and the way you think, man. That's what the word government means. Word government means to control your mind, man. Controlling of the mind. Look it up.
I.e. example. The major networks have all signed on to put blacks in starring roles in these upcoming sitcoms for this fall.
Yep.
To put Negroes back in front of the television so they can control your mind, because last year during this time, there was uprisings of the people.
Yep.
And black folks did not go out and shop on Black Friday. We cost America a lot of money during Black Friday, and they don't want that to happen again. So right now there's about 20-some shows in the works, yep, starring black people, co-starring black people, just to put Negroes back in front of the television so they can buy Christmas gifts,
yep,
celebrate Thanksgiving. That's all right. Part of the government. The government is orchestrating this.
That's right, man. It's all orchestrated, man. And you people don't even realize, like, this month of October is one of the most darkest
devil
months for the elites, for the witches, man. They do a lot of heavy sacrificing during this time.
That's right.
All right? Don't be surprised when a lot of your children come up missing. It's going to be a lot of sacrifices going on, leading up to your favorite holiday that you're getting ready to celebrate at the end of this month. All right? So you people are already controlled, man. You finna come out here and celebrate
Halloween
and Hallow's Eve, which all goes back to Satan worship, man. It's nothing but demonic
demons
and satanic witchcraft that goes on, and it all ties in to Hallow's Eve and Halloween, man.
That's my tone.
All right? Go ahead, bro.
Oh, that was it on that. Let's keep going. 11 and 12. You just have it there, 11 and 12.
Yeah, that's it. That's
yeah,
it.
That's it.
Yeah, man. So yeah, man, this devil has a short time. So this is vital to you so-called Negroes, Hispanics, and Native Americans, man. The Lord is our salvation is that much nearer, man. You see these type of things going on, that's how you know we're getting that closer to the end. All right? But if you don't wake up, man, you're gonna be caught with your pants down, man. Our people, you ain't gonna see it coming. All right? You can continue to be a nigga, a spick, a hoe, all right? You can continue to be all these things under the heaven except for the people of the Lord if you want to, man. But the Lord's coming back to judge those sad individuals, all right? You comfortable with this lifestyle of being a proud American, all right? And you live by way of this society, man, the American way, you're gonna be destroyed.
Well,
you're gonna be destroyed, man. All right. The day is gonna come where you're gonna be proud to be an American, but you're gonna be a American on fire, man.
Nah.
You're gonna be an American burnt up, man. A burnt up American.
Nah.
That day is coming. All right. So this day is, this thing is speeding up, man. But like the scriptures say, for the elect's sake, he's making the day shorter. All right? Because if this place was to go on any longer, it would be no flesh to be saved. Because we would all be consumed as a people, man. That happened back during the time of Noah, man. But back then, during the time of Noah, it wasn't as worse as it is now. It's actually a lot worse now than it was during the time of Noah, when he flooded the earth. So you can only imagine what the Lord is getting ready to do to this place. And that's coming real soon. It's coming quickly. All right?
I got something right now.
Go ahead, bring it up.
2 Peter 3 and 10. But the day of the Lord will come as a thief in the night.
And the Lord is coming like a thief in the night, man. When the Lord shows up, you people are going to be asleep, man. It's going to be like somebody breaking into your crib at 3 in the morning. All right? You wasn't looking for nobody to break into your crib. But that person got in there and got what they got. All right, and that's what it's gonna be like. The Lord's gonna come back while you people are in your comfort zone. All right, it's gonna be hell going on in other parts of the world, but you people here, you're gonna be so accustomed to the new world order, everything's gonna seem to be all right. But you people gonna be living on the left hand side, man. You're gonna be living allegiance to Satan. All right? And right when this man, when this devil, right when he think that he gonna basically accomplish the biggest accomplishment of his new world order, that's when the Lord's gonna intervene on him. All right? That's when the Lord's gonna come back and take this devil out of his power seat. Give me Job the 20th chapter. Finish that.
Second Peter 2:3-10. But the day of the Lord will come as a thief in the night,
yep,
in which the heavens shall pass away with great noise.
Yep, it's gonna pass away with great noise, man.
Boom.
Meaning this current world, all right, which is the planet Earth, it's gonna be a point in time where it's gonna be a nuclear holocaust, man.
That's right.
And that nuclear holocaust is gonna be real noisy. Because of all of the nuclear silos and the noise that it makes when it gets shot off out of a silo into the atmosphere. All right? And then the loud